My name is Christian von Koenigsegg. I'm 40 years old, and for half of my life, I've been on the quest to be a leader in the hypercar industry, utilizing Swedish design combined with visionary technical solutions. Our latest car, the Agera R, is built in the old hangars of a former Swedish fighter jet squadron. Their symbol, a ghost, is now proudly painted on the back of every Koenigsegg. So we're in Koenigsegg's engine and transmission department, and I'm going to show a little bit some unique details about our transmission. The transmission is a very important part in order to make the car do what it's supposed to do. Corner well, have great traction going forward, and also good stability during braking and entry in a corner. So it might surprise some people that the transmission has great influence on all of those aspects, but it actually does. For example, the differential hugely influences the way the car behaves in a corner. In order to have great traction, one needs to have some sort of a differential locking device to make sure that you don't get the wheel with the least resistance to spin. The problem is that if you lock too much, the car doesn't really want to turn, especially if you have a rear-wheel drive car. So it needs to be open and locked when needed in order to get maximum performance. So what we did, we developed our own electronic differential, which sits inside here. You can see this black lid here. It's manufactured here in Skåne in Angelholm and designed by us. And it incorporates a hydraulic piston in this area, which is pressurized by a hydraulic line that comes here from our gearbox management system. And when needed, we get a hydraulic pressure here pushing this piston out, compressing the discs of the differential that sits inside here, giving more or less lock to the differential. This gives the possibility to have a more open differential mid-corner to reduce understeer, give a little bit more lock exiting the corner, and giving a lot of lock in the case of sudden lift-off oversteer to stabilize the car. So basically, it makes a mid-engine car much easier to handle, gives it higher cornering speeds, and the possibility to put more power down during the exit of the corner. So it's really instrumental to the behavior of the whole car. Another very, very interesting feature is at the back of this transmission here. Here inside we have something we call a wet clutch, and people might wonder what is a wet clutch and what is the opposite, meaning a dry clutch. So at the front here between the gearbox and engine we have a normal dry clutch, and dry clutch means that it's just clutch plates which are being pressed together with spring force that you can open, and they're freely spinning in air. There is no moisture around them, it's just dry environment pretty much. But a wet clutch is a clutch that is in an environment of oil. It basically does the same thing, but instead of being surrounded by atmosphere or air, the normal atmosphere or air, it's surrounded by some type of fluid like in this case gearbox oil. And here at the back we actually have a wet clutch. It looks like this. It's very tiny because it's space limited, and due to the fact that it's small in diameter, we need a lot of discs to get the desired force of locking when we use the clutch. So if you look here, you can spin this shaft here, you have 11 discs here, and if I put just a little bit of pressure here with my finger, I can't spin it at all, and if I release I can spin it. And here we put several hundred kilos of pressure when we activate the clutch. And what this does, it's sitting in here, it when we open the main clutch, at the same time as that happens, we lock the input shaft at the end of the input shaft with this hydraulic clutch or slash brake, hydraulic brake it could also be called. to instantly drop the speed drastically of the input shaft. So when we're shifting gears, we don't have to wait for the synchros to equalize the speed between the gears. That has already happened with the help of this wet clutch. So basically, we're getting an AMT, an automated manual transmission, to act with synchros, to act as fast as if it had dog rings. We basically have zero synchronization time. We only have clutch time, not clutch time and then synchronization time. It's already pre-synchronized with this wet clutch. And this is something quite revolutionary because it means that we can have shift times that are so minute that it doesn't really make sense to have a dual clutch gearbox with much more complexity, weight, and therefore not therefore it's not possible to have the same torque capability within the same weight and space constraint as this gearbox. So it's basically taking an AMT technology to the limit, making it shift as fast as a dog ring gearbox, drastically reducing the torque to torque time it takes to shift, but not sacrificing weight, space, and normal drivability. So we really like this solution. And the weight of this gearbox is 81 kilos, and it's the lightest, by far the lightest hypercar gearbox we've ever seen or heard of. And we're quite happy that we have managed in-house with our small engineering team to take it to the next level with these items to make it the state-of-the-art gearbox there is today for a hypercar.